Good morning, one and all. Myself, Dr. Swati N, first year MD scholar from the Department of Panchakarma, IPGTRI, Jamnagar. Today, I am going to present on role of Ayurveda in prevention and management of lifestyle disorders. To attain dharma, artha and sukha, Ayu is considered as the moola. Ayurveda is the science of life. Hitahitam, sukham, dukham, Ayu is the hitahitam is told in our science. Ayurveda teaches us what is beneficial and what is harmful life, what is happy and what is sorrowful life. Ayu is the combination of sharira, indriya, sattva and atma, by which we come to know that Ayurveda includes physical, mental, social and spiritual health. Ayurveda focuses on both swasthya rakshana as well as vikara prashamana. For swasthya rakshana, Ayurveda acharyas advise dinacharya, ratricharya, rutucharya, sadvrata, Tayopastambha, Ashtahara Vidvishesha Ayatana, Dwadashashana Pravicharana, Panchakarma and Rasayana. When the above mentioned advices are not followed properly, there will be manifestation of disorders which may be Shariraja Vikara or Manasa Vikara. According to Aston psychologist Alfred Adler, the term lifestyle is a person's basic character established in early childhood. Lifestyle disorders are the outcome of the way which we lead our lives. The nature of living in olden era was different from the way which we live today. That's why lifestyle disorder has become a great challenge nowadays. Why this topic? Incidence of obesity, diabetes mellitus, PCOD, cancer, Alzheimer's disorders, etc. are drastically increasing due to lack of exercise, unhealthy dietetics and daily regimens. According to WHO, lifestyle disorders kill 41 million people each year, equivalent to 71% of total deaths globally. Each year, 15 million people die between the ages of 30 to 69 years. Over 85% of these premature deaths in low and middle income countries. Cardiovascular disease account for most non-communicable disease deaths, that is 17.9 million people annually, cancer 9 million, respiratory disorder 3.9 million and diabetes mellitus 1.6 million. And the risk factors for the lifestyle disorders are physical inactivity, high blood pressure, tobacco use, obesity, alcohol, etc. And these diseases are driven up by the forces that include rapid unplanned urbanization, globalization of unhealthy lifestyles, and population aging. In India, lifestyle disorders cause 61% of deaths in a year. Almost 23% are at the risk of premature deaths due to such diseases. The three main culprits for the lifestyle disorders are Asatmendriya Artha Sanyoga, Prajnaparadha and Parinama. In Janapada Dvamsakara Adhyaya, Vayu, Udaka, Desha and Kala are considered as the four main factors for the destruction of the health if we shake it. And nowadays we are facing various types of pollution in the form of air, water and soil and also the burning issues like global warming which are nothing but due to the result of Prajnaparadha. And the Parihara is also set in our science in the form of Panchakarma, Veshaja and administration of Rasayana. Nidana are basically classified under three headings, that is Aharaja, Viharaja and Manasika. Consumption of Ushna, Tikshna and Vidahi Ahara in the form of junk food, cold drinks, etc. are not only vitiating the doshas but also causing the depletion of the dhat. And when coming to the Viharaja and Manasika Nidana, compromising the health for the development of the career, irregular working hours, spending less time with the friends and family and more with the mobile and internet, and to reach the given target, taking more stress. And the Parihara is said as Nidana Parivarjan is the prime line of management and also the Nidana Viparita Vishaja. By the above said Nidana, weight of an individual is increasing drastically, which needs Apadarpana Chikitsa, and the depletion of the Dhatu needs Purana Chikitsa. And coming to the Ahara. Consumption of the ahara according to the matra helps in digestion of the food. And coming to the other, that is the Dwadashashana Pravicharana and Ashtahara Vidivishesha Ayatana, which guides us regarding the quality, quantity, place and time factors, which are the main factors for the digestion and the metabolism of the food. Ayurveda also focused on the Manasa Bhava because even though the person takes Pratyahara in a proper matra, if he is afflicted with the Chinta Shogadi Bhava, he won't undergo proper digestion. And the viharas are mentioned in the form of dinacharya, which includes anjana, gandusha, pratimarsha nasya, etc. And also the concept of sadvrutta, that is the guidelines of achara to be followed in our day-to-day life. Rutucharya includes rutushodhana, which helps in which controls the prakopa of the dosha, which got sanchaya in a particular ritu. And the ritu sandhicharya helps in acclimatization of the body in the transitional period of one ritu to another. Panchakama serves as both preventive as well as curative measure. And some of the curative measures as shown in the slide, that is taulya, prameha and kushta, are well managed with the panchakarma. And coming to the concept of rasayana. Rasayana helps in the helps as a immunomodulatory and also that helps in rejuvenation of the depleted vati. And some of the listed disorders related to the memory intelligence like Alzheimer's, Parkinson's disorders are well managed with the Vedya Rasayana. And the Achara Rasayana, that is the ethical behavior, helps in maintaining the mental health. So the lifestyle adaptation is the key in preventing lifestyle disorders. Ayurveda has put special emphasis on both prevention and management of the lifestyle disorders through ahara, vihara and achara.